Hey everybody, welcome back to Keeping It Real in the Kitchen. I'm Candace Cole. Today we're making a roaster recipe, that's why you're here. I know how much you guys love them. I have a few. If you haven't seen them, check them out. But today we're cooking a whole chicken, like a rotisserie chicken, but it's not gonna be rotisserized, it's gonna be roasterized. We're making it in the roaster oven. It's a pretty simple recipe. I think you guys are gonna have no problem with it, so let's get to it. What you're gonna need? Well, you're gonna need a whole chicken. I've got one. Mine's only about 4 pounds. You can cook a big chicken in here because I have cooked a big turkey in here. It's not gonna be a problem. It's just gonna take you a little longer. You're also going to need whatever you wanna season it with. You can make that a lemon pepper chicken. You can stuff it with a lemon inside. You could put like, I don't know, other things inside of that cavity if you'd like to, go for it. You can use salt and pepper, that's classic, that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna spice mine up with just a little bit of garlic and also gonna be using some butter on there. But like I said, guys, you could do a chili chicken. You could do whatever you want. Simple recipe, really easy to customize. Let's get to it. First thing we're gonna do, guys, is get our roaster oven preheated at 450 degrees with the rack inside. My rack's in there. I'm gonna turn this on and get it heating up. All right, we've got that roaster oven preheating with the lid on. I didn't say that. You're gonna wanna put the lid on. That helps keep the heat all inside. Now we're gonna open up our chicken. We're gonna pat it dry with some paper towels. Make sure your chicken is thawed. That's very important. This is not a recipe for a frozen chicken. And we're just gonna pat it dry. Okay, too much. She's dried. When handling chicken, you're going to be washing your hands a lot because you're going to touch other things and then you don't want to get your chicken blood hands and pre-cooked chicken germs on other things. You can melt down your butter to give it a buttery bath and just baste it with it. You can do chunks of butter, put it inside the cavity, under the wings, wherever you like. Buttery bath, buttery bath. Everybody loves a chicken buttery bath. That's my piece for the top. I'm going to put some in your wings, girl. Washing our hands again. I'm gonna try to only use one hand now. I'm gonna salt and pepper it. I'm using kosher salt. It's thicker. Generously season it. There's no reason not to be generous unless you don't have a lot of salt or pepper and you've run out, which does happen. Happens to me a lot. And I'm like, how are we out of this again? Maybe we use too much. I don't know. Did not sneeze. What? You could put whole cloves of garlic in here, inside, in its cavity. You could chop it up, mince it, and put it on top. My garlic is all mushed up, I gotta get it around there. If you saw my video where I use this thing, this is my first time using it, squishing up some garlic. You can see my review. I will tag that video in the end of this one. All right, guys, that chicken is seasoned and ready to go. I do see a bald spot. See that? I do too. Need a little pepper there. It is time to place the chicken inside the roaster oven. Here we go. Putting it in. Boom. Good to go. I'm gonna cover that up. If you have one of these awesome thermometers, this is a Taylor version, you stick it in, you leave it on the outside, you're gonna wanna put this in. Chicken needs to cook to 165 degrees. This is the best way to do it. You don't even need a timer, this just tells you everything. Put it inside. I should have done mine already. I didn't. I said I should have done mine already because when you're cooking in your roaster oven, you don't really wanna open up that lid too much. It takes a long time to get that, not really a long time, but you know, it takes a little while to get that heat stored back up in that roaster, and that's what's cooking it. So we have it cooking at 450 degrees. We're gonna do that just for 7 minutes. That's it. This is gonna help crisp up that chicken. So that's where we're at. Let's let it cook 7 minutes and then I'll be back. Okay, it's been that 7 minutes at that 450 degrees. Now we're gonna lower it to 350 degrees. Let's do that. We lowered it to that 350 and now it's gonna cook till it's the internal temperature of 165 or about 15 minutes per pound. So this is 4 pound turkey. I would multiply 4 by 15. That's how many minutes it needs to cook for. I prefer to do it the temperature way. It just seems to work a little better. Roaster ovens seem to cook things a little faster than everything else. It's about 20 minutes per pound in the oven. This can be 10 to 15 minutes per pound in a roaster, sometimes even a little less. That's why that internal temperature is so important. Also, once your chicken is done or you believe it to be done, whether it's cook time or temperature time, make sure you cut it open, make sure it's not pink inside, and make sure all the juices are running clear. You don't want to see blood. It's not done. Very simple. Blood, not done.
This
chicken is smelling so good. I know it's that garlic in there. And my thermometer said we are at that 165 degree deliciousness. Let's see the chicken. First time together. There it is. It's steamed up my camera. It smells so good and it sounds good, making noise. We didn't put any liquid in the bottom at all. Anything you see down there came from the chicken itself. You saw everything I did.
If you would like to, when you pull your chicken out, you can let it rest for just about 10 minutes. Loosely cover your chicken with some aluminum. Don't make it tight on there. I just have it placed on there. Give it about 10 minutes to rest if you would like to. That makes the juices and makes your chicken a little bit more moist. But man, this chicken is moist. A lovely crispy skin, just right, how I like it, and just in time for lunch. Let's try it. I cooked mine just till the internal temperature. I didn't even time it. I made sure that my juices were running clear before I pulled it out. Sometimes those timers can be a little tricky and they lie to you. I want to get a little bit of skin because I want to taste the flavor of the garlic that I've been smelling. Oh. Oh, that skin is so good. That skin turned out so just right, crispy, and great flavor. I love garlic and it's covered. Chicken, moist. I'm gonna get you an up close shot of that. All right, everybody, thanks so much for watching. I know I'm ready for lunch because I want to eat this buttery garlic skin. Let me know below in the comments what you like to put on your chickens. I hope you give this recipe a try. Thanks so much for watching Keeping It Real in the Kitchen. Be sure to subscribe, like this video, watch some old ones, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.